thank you very much. So thanks for inviting me. Apologies for not being able to be there with you in Bonn today. Hopefully there will be other opportunities. But thanks again for giving this opportunity as well to introduce EUSPA to your audience in the General Assembly, because I think it's important. Even if I have been presenting what is EUSPA and what is our role a lot lately, but I think it's never enough, and there are always new people and new things that can be explained. So let me go just a little bit of introduction of EUSPA for those that still don't know who we are and what is our role. So as Stan said, this is EUSPA stands for European Union Agency for the Space Program, a design agency that was created last year in May, following the new space regulation, and wanting to put under the same umbrella all the different EUSPA components. So for the programs, considering the navigation programs, Galileo and EGNOS, but also the Earth Observation Program, Copernicus, and the new programs that are being created, such as GovSatCom for secure communications for governmental users, or SSA, Space Situational Awareness. For all the different programs, we have different responsibilities. There are some transversal responsibilities, for example, in terms of security accreditation, or some activities on market development, trying to increase the market uptake of these services, in which we have some responsibilities in all the components. But that's why me being part of the market development team and this session talking about market uptake. So let me explain you a little bit what is the work that we do. And it's based on the work that we have been doing, because EUSPA, even if it's 1 year old, but it's leveraging from the agency, the European Navigation Agency, GSA, that had more than 10 years working on this for Galileo and EGNOS. So the way that we work in market development, and the way that we want to still do the same for Copernicus to increase the market uptake, is on these three pillars that you see on the screen, which basically on the left side is talking about market and user knowledge. So it's very much related to the previous presentation on user intelligence. Here we have two main activities, which are the market and technology monitoring, and the what we call the user consultation platform, that at the end is the user intelligence. These are continuous processes that they have some outcomes that I will show later on. Then we have the demand support, which was very important for GNSS, because it was the work that we're doing directly with manufacturers to make sure that they were ready to implement the services, so then they could be put in the market. For Earth observation, for Copernicus in particular, we see it more as a top-down approach, in which we support the different communities, the different regulatory environments at the industrial level. So then it's easier to put these services in the market. So the users can adopt it also through the technological benefits, but also through a stronger regulatory environment in which we can support. And then at the end, we should see what we call the offer creation, that is all the set of tools for research and development, but also for entrepreneurship, in which we want to support the downstream market to create new solutions using these different space services. The way that we work is more or less in different verticals. So trying to know, understand what are the particularities of each market, because that is crucial for understanding what are the trends, what are the specific user needs, that you cannot look at the service in general, but at the specific applications and level needs that are particular for different type of users. And this is the market segmentation that we have come up with. It's a little bit complex, I would say, for sure if you're thinking about it. Also because we are trying to provide an integrated approach with GNSS and Earth observation. So there are some segments in which GNSS it's more important. That's, for example, all the transport segments with road, rail, aviation, But there are other segments in which obviously Earth observation and Copernicus in particular can play a key role, like biodiversity, climate services, environmental monitoring. But still, we believe that in all of the segments, there are a lot of synergies. And when we talk about synergies, we talk about joint use of positioning services of GNSS and Earth observation. Can be in different phases of an application, can be together, depending on the case. So we are trying to foster this. And specifically, what has to be clear, the role of EUSPA to complement the work that the entrusted entities are doing, then the work that the Copernicus services are doing, engaging currently the core users. So our focus is to complement that, focusing on the what we call other users, the commercial users, in which there has been a lot of effort put, of course, into that. But we want to, let's say, drive that, structure that a little bit more through EUSPA. Addressing the creation of new solutions that what we call is are more revenue oriented. So those solutions and services that generate revenues that can be commercial and then generate some benefits and values for the citizen eventually. We are now preparing a strategy. Of course, we have been working for the last year together with the Commission, together with the trusted entities, to see how to define a role and complementarity so there are no overlaps. And we are now working on a strategy, on a market uptake strategy focused on other users and commercial users. So this has several activities related to what I was saying before, trying to understand the market, in the downstream market a little bit better, the users, trying to identify what are the needs and gaps in terms of what we call geospatial monitoring. So needs that can be addressed by Earth observation, by Copernicus, but kind of could also be addressed by something else like IoT monitoring, other type of sensors, other type of technologies. And then we will have some different tools, the R&D tools, but also some tools like developing use case, developing pilots. Outcome of these, we will provide and publish best practices standards for individual work that we're doing with specific industries. And for all this, we are working with the trusted entities and the Commission. And this we want to be a continuous process in which we are going to tightly work together in order to produce the best results and the most successful results. So this is one of the main outcomes that we have with when we talk about market monitoring. This is Earth Observation Genesis Market Report. The first edition, the joint edition, was published in January. So before we were doing only GNSS market report, but now we published the first Earth Observation and GNSS market report, covering all the segments that that you see on the screen that I mentioned before. You can, of course, download the report and you will get more information on the segments. In this report, we showed what are the trends on these specific industries, what is the use of GNSS and Earth observation in these industries, and also we provide a forecast on the market, so the amount of revenues that are being generated in terms of, in this case, Earth observation and GNSS currently, and forecast in the future in the next 10 years. The other action that I mentioned before is the user consultation platform. This is complementary to the previous presentation, and this is one of the topics that we're currently discussing with ECMWF, is on the collection of user needs and requirements, try to identify the users and characterize them so we know better what are their needs and how the current service offering of Earth observation can map to those needs. Now this year we have started this process, which has a central meeting in October, the 3rd of October, and we have started with a small subset of all these segments, so in order to be able to focus it and do these exercises for the first time, so we can concentrate and produce relevant results. These are the segments that that you see on the screen that will be addressed this year. Here again, we are working together with ECMWF to try to engage the users that they were already using CAM services, for example, for these segments. So we want to work together with them to continue the work that we had that they have been doing, and also in the definition of the requirements, so we can homogenize the definition of those requirements, so we can, let's say, talk the same language when we are providing these definitions. So you, of course, are invited to participate. There will be a call for open to for registration. So this event will be made in Prague on the 3rd of October. Finally, let me talk about the different funding opportunities that we have. We have two main tools when we talk about Copernicus and Earth observation. This is Horizon Europe calls and the Cassini initiative. For Horizon Europe, we had the first call last year, which is already closed and is now under evaluation. And the main call that was including Copernicus was this first one that you see. It was called Genesis and Copernicus Applications Fostering the European Green Deal. This was a generic title, quite a generic call, so any type of application would fit, but of course it had to focus to address the objectives that were specified in the call. Now for this next second call that will be published in October and with deadline in February next year, we have different topics. And if we specifically for Copernicus, we have one PCP, pre-commercial procurement action, that's called public sector as Galileo or Copernicus user. Then we have two other calls, one innovation action and one research and innovation action, mostly focused on data. The first one focused on data economy and more on the solving solutions for societal challenges, for specific industrial challenges, and this is the innovation action, so it has to be an application close to the market. And the second one, that is, we're looking for solutions that are trying to solve artificial intelligence or high-performance computing issues related to the management of large volumes of data coming from Copernicus, but also the possibility of integrating with different types of other data. And this is a research innovation action, so the TRL that is expecting is lower, but the level of disruptiveness, if you want, of the research to be produced has to be higher. Then we have Cassini, in which we have different tools. We have hackathons, we have prizes, we have matchmaking, in which we are trying to put together entrepreneurs with venture capital firms, for example. And we have what we call seed and grant funding facility, in which we are collaborating with different entities like the European Investment Fund, the European Investment Bank, to help these entrepreneurs that have created solutions based on EUSPA-based data and services to grow. So it's not only to give them a prize for an idea, but also to help them grow to go into the market. And finally, we have other tools. This is something that you might have seen. We published last month. It's what we call Copernicus demonstrators. This is in line with other activities that have been done in the past, trying to showcase use cases that can show the benefits of using Copernicus, Copernicus data in different areas. What we are looking is at even the implementation of the proof of concept, in which we can involve even the final
Edward,
user.
Can you close in half a minute?
Yes, of course. And this is open for applications for the 2nd of September. You can find all the specifications in the link below. And particularly, just to close and to specify the collaboration that we are doing with this MWF in different areas. So one is on the user characterization, such as the presentation that you saw before. This is very important in order to establish a proper strategy and harmonize the way that we are collecting data. The same with the user requirements or monitoring of different key performance indicators of market uptake. And we want to evolve with CMWF and other partners in the use cases and demonstrators and to use their knowledge and expertise for technical support and validation. So it will be a continuous collaboration. So this was my last slide.
Thanks a lot, Edward. Is there a question for Edward?